Hi guys, good evening. Hi everyone. Hello. What's up? Hi. A very warm welcome to the session. How's it going, guys? Hi, Suchi, Bhargavi, Shreyash. Good evening. I'm absolutely fine and I'm really glad that you're super excited. So am I. How is everyone? Let's get started. Hi Shri Ganesha, Suchi, Shreyash, Bhargavi, Mohit. Hi, welcome to the session. Hi Joseph, hello bacche. See your need. Oh my God. Hi, see your need. Good evening. Hello. Okay. So people, let's get started with today's session. I am here with another one-shot session for ICSE 10. Today we are going to do our geography chapter, soil resource. How many of you are super excited because you kind of found this a little boring? And I'm really excited that in next few minutes this will be entirely understood, once again revised. Good, amazing. Suresh, Hanji, बोलिए Suresh, what's up? Vanshika, hello. Hi Priya. Hi Vachan Shri. Good evening, Mohit Bachcha. Hello, Ayush. Hi everyone. Hello. Hi Rini. Yes, date sheet is out for CBSE and the social science paper is on 27th. So if we have CBSE students over here, how are you guys feeling? Do tell me. Hi Katyayani, hi Mehdi Abbas, hello Bachcha, hi Mustafa Azam, hello, hi, welcome. Shreyash, it is. Soil resources is helpful because types of soil we do have to do in the syllabus for CBSE. Hi Tripti. Okay, people, so I am Ankana, your master teacher for social sciences at Vedanta, hoping all my dear students are doing absolutely fine and amazing. Let's get started with today's session, soil resource. Now, before I start, first we need to understand what are we going to talk about. किस बारे में बात होने वाली है? What are we even going to refer to? What is soil? But the soil is formed due to different weathering conditions, weathering of mountains, hills, and then these particles basically break down the stones, and because of friction, they actually rub against each other and change into a powdery, loose material. That is what is known as soil, because it forms the top layer of the earth. The very first thing that comes on the surface of the earth is soil. So it is essentially the loose material which forms the thin layer, surface layer of earth. Correct? Right? Tech high five. Hello. Hanji Dey. No, there is no mentee today. The video is blurred. Is it? Manshika, is it okay now? Hi Ramit. अरे क्या बात है, रमित का पेपर बहुत अच्छा हुआ है. कांग्रेचुलेशंस, कांग्रेचुलेशंस. आई एम रियली प्राउड ऑफ यू. नो सुरेश, आज मेंटी नहीं होगा बच्चा. वी डू नॉट हैव मेंटी टुडे. ओके साहिल, हेलो. हाय धेई खैरियत, हेलो. इट्स आई थिंक इट्स नॉट ब्लर्ड एनी मोर. आई वुड रिक्वेस्ट यू टू इंक्रीज द रेजोल्यूशन ऑफ योर वीडियो. गाइस, यू कैन हियर मी एंड सी मी फाइन, राइट? यस मोहित, थैंक यू सो मच. पीपल हु आर वॉचिंग द वीडियो, do not forget to hit the like button. Make sure to hit the like button if you are excited for the session, and because we have already started, if you are enjoying the session. Subedar, Subedar, chalo chalo jaldi se. Apramya, hello. Atharv, hi. Mohitra. Okay guys, Katayani. So that is what soil is, the very top layer, the powdered thing. Okay, now what makes it so important that we are talking about it, that we are studying about it? Of course, it's a natural resource and everything, but there has to be something that it is doing very important and contribution that it has in people's life, that we are doing an entire chapter over it. It definitely is. Why? It supports the plants, it supports the animals, it supports the human life directly, indirectly, in so many ways. Guys, you cannot imagine your life without soil. The plants will not grow. What will the humans and the animals feed on? Where will the animals live? There's so many things, there's so many questions. What will happen if the soil is not there? Simple as that. I can't imagine, right? So soil is a supporting element for humans, for animals, for plants, everyone. Every kind of life depends on soil. So soil kind of forms the base, right? It forms the base of life. So soil forms the base of life is what you can say. So because the plants that grow over there provide food to animals, they provide food to humans. Soil is a source of food for so many other beings, the microorganisms, everything that is staying in it. So it basically supports the life and is forming the base, the fundamental of a life, of the life of human lives, okay, and in general others as well. So agriculture production also depends on them, and that is where we, which is humans, get their food from. Correct? That is what makes the soil very, very important. Correct? Nash, Sai Siddharth, hello, hi. Hi, Mohit. What's up? Hanji. So now we're going to talk about the different types of soil. See, bacha, as I was telling you that how is soil formed, okay? If I talk about the formation of soil, okay, let me quickly switch the screen. If I talk about formation of soil, how did it happen? It happened because of rain, it happened because of storm, it happened because of wind, it happened because of volcanic eruptions, right? It happened due to multiple reasons, right? Weathering and so many things that are responsible for the current soil formation. Now my point over here is that if this was happening all around the world, was it same everywhere? No, it was not. Guys, do you relate to this? Was it same everywhere? Yes, boy, it's a short and a very interesting chapter. Was it same everywhere? Okay, I'll use a different color. I guess this is visible now, right? Ye visible hai. Theek hai? Shreyash, is this fine now? Okay, it was not, bacha. Because everywhere the process of soil formation, right? The process of soil formation was different. There were different conditions involved. There were different types of materials that were involved. Somewhere it was the volcanic, somewhere it was igneous rock, somewhere it was the mountains, snow-capped mountains, somewhere it was the volcanic eruptions which had dried down. So it depends a lot of things, and that determines the different types of soils. So the Indian Council of Agriculture Research, which is ICAR, set up an All India Soil Survey Committee in 1953. Guys, remember the name of the committee, the name of the research center and the year in which the committee was formed to do this survey. And they divided the Indian soil into the following major groups. So we have alluvial, black, red and laterite soil. Now we're going to understand what are these soil alluvial. But this is formed near the plains. Aapko plains mein ye dekhne ko milega, which plains? Northern plains, as you know. So basically, Indus, Ganges and Brahmaputra, the river system, okay, they are responsible for a particular deposition of soil, okay, which is nothing else but the alluvial soil. So occupy an area of around 15 lakh kilometer square, which is 45.6% of the total area of the country. So around half of the country, you would say half of the land actually has alluvial soil. Now it's not just available in the north, it is also available a little bit in the eastern ghats and a little bit here and there in patches, but majorly in the northern plains. Some coastal plains also you can find alluvial soil in. Okay, Mohit Agarwal, what is not visible? So sweet, Ullas Mahajan, welcome to this session. Sai Mahajan, hi. Usma, we do not have Menti Bacha. Okay, सो सपोर्ट द मैक्सिमम शेयर ऑफ एग्रीकल्चरल प्रोडक्ट. ओके बच्चा, एज यू नो, वी नो दैट स्टेट्स ऑफ पंजाब, हरियाणा एंड यू नो यूपी एटसेट्रा, ऑल दीज आर स्टेट्स वेर लॉट ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर प्रोडक्शन हैपन्स. वाई? बिकॉज द सॉइल ओवर हियर इज रियली सपोर्टिव फॉर द एग्रीकल्चर प्रोडक्शन. सो इट इज पॉसिबल टू डू दैट. And that is why we are saying that the maximum share of agriculture products are derived from the soil which is available in these states. That is why these states are also known as granary of India. So it has originated from the transported alluvium brought by rivers. So bacha, there are two kinds of soils. Okay, one is transported and one is original. Okay, transported soil is basically the soil which is formed somewhere else and by some agent, it could be water, wind, anything, has been transported, has been transferred to a new area where you actually find it in abundance. So these soils are actually formed on the mountains, but they are taken away from there by the running rivers and they have been deposited it in the plains, and that is why these are the largest transported soil and are also known as river soil, because of course you can see the whole river system is responsible for its deposition. Guys, understood? Yes, Shreyash, whatever is written this side. ठीक है? So now we are going to talk about types of alluvial soil and what is different. So bacha, there are two kinds of alluvial soil. One is old, one is new. The new soil or the comparatively young soil is known as khadar and the old soil is known as bhangar. ठीक है? Now what is the difference between these two? So this is new. So naturally this is newer and younger and this is older. ये पहले से formed है. This has already been formed for a longer period of time. Now these contain fine sand and clayey material and also because of which they are more fertile. Also bacha, in a simple way, if you have to remember in terms of quality, anything which is new will have more taste, more fertility, everything, right? Nayi cheez mein zyada jaan hoti hai. New things are more shiny, more beautiful, more colorful, but as they grow old, they kind of lose all those elements. Similarly, the old bhangar soil is less fertile. Now one thing also to remember is that it contains a lot of kankar pebbles in gravel, small stones, coarse kind of texture is what it has, whereas the new one is more clay, and what is more clayey is more fertile. The where there is more kankar, which is also there in sand, is less fertile. So that is also one way to remember in terms of fertility. Then they are pale brown in color, whereas they are darker in color and vary from light gray to ash gray. See, this is new. So you remember, soil is usually of brown color, right? So if it is of brown color, these ones are pale brown because they're like new. What starts getting old, it will start drying up. So it will turn into darker shades, but the shades vary from gray to ash color. What do we mean by ash color? But it is dark gray. Whenever you burn something, you have the ash remaining. The shade of that ash is what is the color of the old bhangar alluvial soil. They are found at the lower levels near the rivers. So, jahan pe rivers come and deposit, along with them, they bring the new alluvial soil. Whereas they are found 30 meter above the flood level of the river. So, it's a little above and beyond the rivers. Okay? Got it everyone? Shiv Bardhan, Mohit, Subedar, Bhangar and Khadar, Indrapreet. Exactly. Yes, bacha, Dibya, absolutely. हाँ जी, डेट शीट आ गई. सीबीएसई स्टूडेंट्स, डेट शीट आ गई है. योर सोशल साइंस एग्जाम इज ऑन 27th एंड आई थिंक इंग्लिश इज बिफोर दैट, राइट? इंग्लिश इज इन द बिगिनिंग इटसेल्फ. आई एम फॉरगेटिंग द डेट. या रोहन, थैंक यू सो मच. यस मोहित, थैंक यू सो मच. गाइस, हिट द लाइक बटन एंड make as many likes as possible. Get it as many likes as possible. It just makes me feel good if you do that. Let's have a target of 100. Let's try and achieve 100 in next half an hour and I will move forward. Now what are the characteristics, what are the features, right? We are going to talk about the features of the soil. How do you identify the soil? How does the soil behave? So bacha, we know that it is a transported soil, which means it is actually formed. Now I'll tell you quickly what exactly happens with this soil. Now it's time to change the screen again. Now these are the Himalayas, okay? Let's say these are the Himalayas, okay? And the rivers are flowing from here. सो आई विल 1 मिनट क्विकली चेंज टू दिस. या सो द रिवर्स आर फ्लोइंग फ्रॉम योर ओके लाइक दिस एंड दे माइट बी फ्लोइंग लाइक योर योर दिस वे. Now, when they are flowing from here, bacha, because it is so steep at this place that it will actually wash off the first layer of the soil, and that is the layers that it carries itself and that brings it and deposits it here. This is where it gets deposited, and this is what is known as the alluvial soil. So you see, it is actually formed here, but it's transported to this place. So that is what your soil is, this particular soil, alluvial soil is, and that is why we say it is transported, because it was formed somewhere else and it is deposited somewhere else. These soil are coarsest in the upper section and in of the valley, and medium in the middle, and finest in the delta region. See, this is where you have the new soil, and this is where you have the these two places where you have the old soil. We have already seen that the old soil contains kankar. So kankar is more coarse, but it starts getting fine and clayey towards the river, towards the delta. That is why you find the finest materials over here, which is the new soil, khadar soil, right? Bhangar soil is on the above 30 meters away. Now, what kind of crops do we have here? Again, bacha, as I've told you, remember, recall, Punjab, Haryana, UP, a little bit of Rajasthan, a little bit of Gujarat. What kind of crops do they cultivate? So they have wheat, they have sugarcane, rice, cotton, oil seeds, pulses. All of these things can be millets. Can be easily grown here. These are few more things that you can add. And the delta region are ideal for cultivation of jute, because over here water is more and fertility of the land is more, and jute requires a lot of water. So near the delta region, water will be more available in abundance, right? Clear? Bacha, delta hi alluvium, delta ke pas, near the delta, simple, fertility, very very fertile. Bacha, alluvial soil in general is very fertile, and that is why it is a very good fit for agriculture, and so many crops can be grown in this type of soil. So they respond well to irrigation and mowing, and very good for rabi and kharif crop. So both winter and monsoon crop can be grown over here. That is why we see that both wheat and rice is very well grown over here, right? So they respond very well to irrigation. Irrigation is what? Artificial method of adding water. I mean, like if rain is not there, you need an alternative. So artificial method of putting water into the fields, into the land. So that if you do irrigation with alluvial soil, they will respond very very well. We do not makes it, it does not make it very very complicated. Okay, cool. बच्चे प्रज्ञा जैन गुड इवनिंग. हाय बच्चा. गीता डू चेक योर सिस्टम. आई थिंक आई एम ऑडिबल टू एवरीवन. विद्यावर्षिनी अ वेरी वेरी हैप्पी बर्थडे. मे गॉड ब्लेस यू एंड स्टे ब्लेस्ड, स्टे सेफ एंड जस्ट हैव ऑल द सक्सेस एंड द हैप्पीनेस इन द वर्ल्ड. किरण ज्योत नॉट येट. आई एम सो सॉरी टू से दैट. यस cool. Hi Pragya. Hi Bachi. Hi Rahil. Hi Karan. Hello. Now we're going to talk about the areas we find this in. See, you can see northern plains over here. These are the northern plains. I think I should be changing the color of my pen. And yeah, so northern plains, this is where you find, and then I told you eastern ghats ke patches pe bhi you can see it a little bit, right? So north India, we find it in the areas of riverine alluvium of Satluj, Ganga and Brahmaputra plains. Rivers, Satluj is basically part of Indus, but because we have Satluj in India, from India the tribute, from Indus the tributary, we are saying Satluj. States of Punjab, Haryana, Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, West Bengal, Assam, all of these have alluvial soil in the north, right? See over here. And then in the south, in the areas of Deccan coastal strip occupying deltas of Godavari, Krishna, Kaveri, Narmada, Tapti, which is this part, right? This part. States of Orissa and some other regions. See a little bit of here, some parts of Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, everywhere you find it in patches. Now we're going to talk about black soil, which is also known as black cotton soil. So when we talk about the crop, you would know what crop are we talking about. But why is it black? It is black because it is formed from the volcanic इरप्शंस, राइट, बिकॉज ऑफ द वॉल्केनिक इरप्शंस द रॉक्स दैट फाइनली सॉलिडिफाइड फ्रॉम देयर वी गेट दिस एंड दैट इज वॉट गिव्स इट द ब्लैक कलर. सो ब्लैक सॉइल आर ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज रेगर एंड ब्लैक कॉटन सॉइल. आई टोल्ड यू ब्लैक कॉटन सॉइल एंड रेगर भी बोलते हैं इसे. दे कॉल्ड द रेसिडुअल सॉइल्स एंड हैव ओरिजिनेटेड फ्रॉम सॉलिडिफिकेशन ऑफ बेसिक लावा स्प्रेड ओवर अ लार्ज एरिया ऑफ डेकन प्लेटो ड्यूरिंग वॉल्केनिक एक्टिविटी. सो आफ्टर वॉल्केनिक इरप्शंस when these things used to cool down, so the lava used to cool down and that would change into the black color from there. Okay, these soils have been formed and that is why they're also known as residual soil, because from the residue, from the leftover of the lavas, what got formed? The soil got formed, which is known as the black soil, right? Hanji Suchi, yes, it definitely is. Perfect. Rohan, I have shown the distribution of the soil over your alluvial soil in the southern region. I would request you to go back to the session and refer to it. You will also have the document with you. Okay. So, therefore, they are essentially formed in the weathering of Deccan Trap. So, where the weathering of in the Deccan Trap is happening, that is where you find it. Now, what are its characteristics? One thing I will tell you, bacha, leaching does not happen in black soil. Why does leaching not happen? Because they have a very high water retention, so they can retain retention, they can retain a lot of water, that is why moisture is very very high, and they are clay in nature, they are clay in nature, so become sticky when wet, clay, right, clay ki jaisa ho jata hai. In some valleys like Narmada and Tapti, the soil is 6 meter deep. Imagine 6 meter deep. Okay, crops, cotton, we know. Sugarcane, you should also remember, because these days from north, sugarcane is actually moving towards this kind of soil and this particular area, southern, south peninsular area. Okay, so cotton, rice, wheat, see, rice, bacha, anywhere where water is in abundance, because rice requires a lot of water, you can find rice being cultivated over there. Then jowar, Virginia tobacco, oil seeds like linseed, sunflower, and fruits and vegetables, all of these crops can be found over here. Fertility, see, anything that is retaining so much of water will be super fertile. So black soil plants are low fertility, but they are dark and rich in valleys. So in valleys where you see, they have good fertility. Otherwise, other places, the fertility is a little low. Okay, now if you talk about color, texture and composting, color we know is black. So vary from deep black to chestnut brown. So dark brown, somewhere it varies, medium brown, or even mixture of red and black is seen. See, this is a type of black soil. So you can see the cracks over here. When will the cracks appear? When the fertility is a little low. They are fine grain in texture with more than 60% clay. I told you, right, it's very clayey in texture. Contains lime, alumina, iron, potash, magnesium and carbonate calcium, and is deficient in phosphate, nitrogen and humus. Areas, Deccan Plateau. Bacha, see, this part of the country, the Deccan Trap, which we call, or the plateau, is where you can find this soil. So remember, Maharashtra, Saurashtra, a little bit of Gujarat, a little bit of Madhya Pradesh, okay, major chunk of Madhya Pradesh, to be honest, some part of Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, southern districts of Tamil Nadu, all of these places you will find this soil available in. Clear? Got it, everyone? Hanji, Mimansa, absolutely. Fagun, hello. Yes, guys, is there a lag? Yes, Anushree, I was just telling that social science is on 27th of May. Zed? I have been taking one shots. Why are you guys so worried? Okay, now moving to red soil. But if I talk about the characteristics and all, you would know one thing, if nothing else, that the color of the soil is red. Now, why is it red? It is because of the presence of iron, phosphorus, right? It gets diffused in it and gives it the red color. Where iron content is less, it is more of yellow brownish shade. One thing to remember about red soil is that. Now, why is it formed? It is formed due to the ancient crystalline and metamorphic rock. So, this is the parent of the You know, these rocks, the metamorphic rocks and ancient crystalline rocks, they are the parent of the red soil. Now, it occupies an area of around 3.5 kilometer square, which is about 10% of the total area of the country. So, after alluvial soil, we see that this might be the biggest. What are the characteristics? Not retentive to moisture, does not retain a lot of moisture. When fertilizers are added, they become productive. So we need to keep working with them. When worked upon, becomes fertile. So it gets fertile when it is worked upon. Okay, it is coarse, porous and crumbly. Dardara sa hota hai, crumbly. Okay, imagine like cornflakes when you crush, how will it look? Coarse, crumbly like that. What kind of crops do we have over here? With application of proper fertilizers and irrigation, they give excellent yield of wheat, rice, cotton, sugarcane, pulses, millets, tobacco and oil seeds. Now, if we talk about the color, texture, composting, I told you, bacha, the red color it gets because of the iron content. Bacha, remember, iron is always associated with red color, and that is why food which is red in color is very rich in iron. For example, pomegranate, for example, beetroot, these have a lot of iron in it. Of course, spinach also has, but otherwise, I'm saying iron, red color, you associate with iron, okay? So, the red color comes because of the high iron content. The color varies from red to brown, chocolate and yellow. See, so when iron content is less, okay, it has not been diffused in such a high rate in the soil, then the color would probably be brown, chocolate and yellowish in shade. It lacks lime, magnesia, phosphate and nitrogen. It is rich in potash and becomes fertile with proper use of fertilizers and irrigation. I told you, right? It can be treated to be super fertile. So if you work on this land, it can easily become very, very fertile and productive, but we need to work on this land. Okay. In North India, bacha, we have it in Bihar, West Bengal, Eastern Rajasthan, etc. And in southern part, we have it in the spread of Tamil Nadu, large parts of the southern Karnataka, Goa, Northeast, Andhra Pradesh, Odisha, Southeast, Maharashtra, and Chota Nagpur Plateau. Now, a quick reminder about the Vedantu Pro subscription, which is going to give you unlimited live classes. Now that you have a clarity about your exams, also for CBSE students, if you're watching this, bacha, all of these quizzes, these help sessions, the notes, that content that you get with handwritten notes, doubt solving tests and assignments, all of this is going to be super sorted. And micro sessions and crash courses have already started for your final exams. Start joining and it will come absolutely free with the Vedantu Pro subscription, making less a lot more. You just have to visit the link given in the description box. It is also pinned in the comment section. You can also go on vdnt.in/ytpro. Just make sure to put the code AKEPRO. If you apply this code, you will get the discount, and you actually do the calculation, it will come down to just 10 rupees and 7.5 rupees till June. So almost 5 months left, and that is just going to cost you 7.5 rupees per session. So definitely lesser than your packet of chips, right guys? So coming back, we will move on. The link is there in the description box, but in the comment section, code is here. Do not forget to use that. The third type of soil, laterite soil. Actually, fourth type of soil. We have done alluvial, we have done black soil, we have done red soil, now laterite soil. The word laterite comes from a Latin word which basically means brick. Okay, it is formed in the conditions of high temperature and heavy rainfall with alternative wet and dry periods. So one, it is wet, then it is dry, then it is wet, then dry. Alternation may it is formed, and it has like formed under high temperature. It is very hot in the areas where it is formed, and rainfall is also pretty high. Okay, it covers about 2.5 lakh square kilometers square. Now, what are its characteristics? So, we can see that conditions were like high temperature and heavy rainfall. So, it must have good retention. So, monsoon conditions promote leaching of the soil. But your leaching of the soil is washing out of the top layer. Which is also the most fertile layer. So all of the nutrients also gets washed out of this. Okay. In other words, heavy rainfall washes away the topsoil containing silica. I told you nutrients also gets washed out, right? This is called leaching. It has a unique property of being valuable building material as they harden like iron when exposed to air. So on hardening, it becomes like iron, like metal. So that is how hard this soil becomes. So now you get that why laterite is being spoken as a brick, because when you harden this, the brick is so strong, right? So that is where the laterite soil gets its name. Now this is also red in color due to the presence of iron oxide. So it has iron oxide in it. It is coarse in texture, it's not very fine, and friable and porous in nature. But usually coarse things would be porous because it would have gaps so that water could pour out, get filtered out of there. Okay, Mimansa, good evening. No lagging at all. Right? Perfect. Hi Shikhavati. Hi Vachcha. Yes, metal like, absolutely. Perfect, Vachcha. Perfect. Lord Hindustan Gamer, no, I do not get bored with this. I love teaching. I do not get bored. Wiz Hearties, how is that information important? Okay, people, on that note, Kavya, I hope you guys are enjoying the session. Do not forget to hit the like button. It is rich in iron because it is also giving it the red color, and poor in lime, magnesium, phosphoric acid and potash. If you talk about fertility, because see, leaching is happening, so a lot of nutrition will get washed off. So naturally, fertility will also drop down. Fertility drops down because of leaching, right? But responds readily to manuring and irrigation, but it can be worked and brought back with proper treatment. So if we treat it properly, if there is a proper treatment, it can be brought back, the fertility can be retained, and it will become productive again. It will definitely be productive again. Got it, everyone? You two like acid. You like acid? You are like acid. What are you saying? Okay, now talk about crops, bacha. Tea, coffee, rubber, coconut, all of these things we can grow in laterite soil. Now we will quickly look at the distribution. So highland areas of peninsular plateau that are summits of western ghats and eastern ghats. So you can see it clearly over here, right? See, pink is your laterite soil. So this part, bit of here, a bit of there, and then here, all of these are your laterite soils. So Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, parts of Maharashtra, Kerala, Bihar, Odisha, Jharkhand, all these have what? Laterite soil. Now with that, we have finished what is soil, we have finished the different types of soil. Now we're going to talk about soil erosion. What is soil erosion? But a removal of the top layer of soil, like leaching mein ho raha tha, right? Removal of top soil, the topmost layer. Again, it also takes away some fertility of along with it, but that is what is known as the erosion. Now there are multiple factors, agents which make it happen. Running water, wind, overgrazing, men, plant, animals, faulty methods of agriculture. Even if agriculture is not done properly, it becomes exploitation of the soil, which ultimately ends up in the erosion of the soil. So that is what it is. See, deforestation occurs the topsoil, exposed topsoil eroded with wind. So deforestation is not there, the soil is not bounded, it will fly away with the wind, all of that will happen. Now we're going to talk about causes. We have already looked at the causes, we'll try and understand. But I showed you the mountain, if you remember, right? I will quickly come back to the screen. I showed you that mountain is steep like this, and I told you that from here water will fall or run by, right? Rivers will run by. What happens when river is running by here? It is taking the top layer. The top layer is taken away by it. Okay. So when the top layer has been taken away by it, it has taken away the nutrients, the top layer, all of it. So that is what happens. This is what is happening in erosion because of the pressure and the speed of the water. You must have seen whenever you throw water at a very high speed, it is very, very, it cuts down through the soil. So that is what happens in soil erosion by running water. So prime factor of soil erosion, indirectly soil erosion helps in soil farming as well. See, bacha, top layer is removed. So what will happen? Now again, now some soil will be formed and that will replace the layer which already exists over here. Okay. Now, see, इरोजन वॉज बाउंड टू हैपन बिकॉज इट ऑल्सो हैपन्स बिकॉज ऑफ नेचुरल कॉजेज. फॉर एग्जाम्पल रेन, रनिंग वाटर, हाई फ्लोइंग विंड. एंड देन यू माइट बी थिंकिंग मैम देन वाई इज सॉइल इरोजन स्टार्टेड हैपनिंग नाउ. दीज थिंग्स, दीज फैक्टर्स एग्जिस्टेड बिफोर ऑल्सो. एब्सोल्यूटली करेक्ट बच्चा, दिस फैक्टर्स एग्जिस्टेड बिफोर ऑल्सो, बट नाउ विद द इंटरवेंशन ऑफ ह्यूमन बींग्स, नाउ दैट वी हैव ऑल्सो स्टार्टेड इंटरक्टिंग विद द नेचर, वी हैव स्टार्टेड एक्सप्लॉइटिंग इट इवन मोर. हम उसे और ज्यादा एक्सप्लॉइट कर रहे हैं. सो द बैलेंस दैट वॉज देयर, वी हैव एक्चुअली डिस्टर्ब द बैलेंस बिटवीन द नेचर. नेचर वॉज काइंड ऑफ डैमेजिंग इट एंड देन वॉज रिप्लेसिंग इट विथ न्यू फॉर्म सॉइल, बिकॉज सॉइल फॉर्मेशन टेक्स अ वेरी लॉन्ग 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 पीरियड ऑफ टाइम. So nature was keeping that balance, but now that human beings interfered, the balance went off. So that is the problem because of which we need to take care of the conservation of the soil, which we will also discuss. So because from where the soil is removed, deposited elsewhere. So bachcha, jahan se, if the soil has been removed from one place, it will actually go and deposit somewhere. So in a way, new soil formation is happening. That is definitely helped by the soil erosion agents, but it is not so good. It disturbs the agricultural pattern and should be prevented from happening. And there are multiple ways of soil erosions because of running water. Now, under running water itself, there are three kinds. One is splash erosion. So, what is happening? Splash. Just think, how many of you have watered a plant in a pot and have tried to pour water in the pot from a great height? How many of you do that? And you may have seen that the soil is getting pulverized. It is getting, you know, splashing here and there, and it is forming a kind of a hole into your pot. Have you seen that? Yeah. Or when you put a lot of pressure with the hose in your pots, the soil will splash everywhere and will create a hole. Right, bacha? That is splash erosion. Okay, with the impact of heavy drops, with the impact of heavy rain or water falling on the soil, it gets pulverized. It spreads out. It could be because of the hailstones, because of heavy rains, that causes splash erosion. Okay. Now, you would have also seen that during rainy season, when you walk from the same pathway, if it is a kaccha road, during a rainy season, if the water is flowing through a particular way, that place, the soil will get cut. Okay, it will get eroded. That is gully erosion or rail erosion. Imagine it in a bigger picture. Okay, you must have seen, correct? So, bachcha, one on step slopes, what happens? In absence of vegetation, water flows with a force. When water is flowing with the force, it is cutting it in its shape. So basically, the shape of the water has been taken and it forms like a gully, like a lane or a rail. Okay, like the tracks of the rail. So the channels are formed through which the water flows, cutting that particular soil in valleys. And then we have sheet. So it is basically a whole sheet, a whole layer of soil has been removed in a form of a sheet. So due to heavy rains, the surface film of water carries away the even surface layer of the topsoil. So these are three. Yes, Shreyash, gully means street or lane. So like a street or lane, the gullies are formed in soil because of erosion due to water. The second cause is wind. Okay, soil erosion can also be caused because of wind. When wind blows with a great velocity, bacha, it carries away soil with it. You may have seen during storms. Bacho, have you feel during storms? If you stand, go and stand in the storm, you feel that some grains of soil, you know, the dust is there on your skin. You feel it on your tongue. Have you felt it? Bacha, have you felt it? Yes? Right? Bacha, laterite soil has less fertility. It is not barren. It can, support with good fertilizers, more water and everything. It can support vegetation. Yes, so basically soil erosion occurs with wind also, right? When wind blows with high velocity, it will blow the particles of soil along with it. So windy dry season for a part of the year blows that. The upper soil surface becomes loose and susceptible to wind erosion due to the lack of moisture. So dry soil, that is why sand and all blows more with the winds, okay? Other causes could be overgrazing. When grazing is done more and more by the animals, what will happen? The vegetation will reduce. So naturally, it will lead to soil erosion. And then, of course, our interference. We are trying to build concrete jungles. So we are trying to cut off the forest, deforestation, plowing, not treating the lands properly, ill practices of agriculture, adding more and more fertilizers, chemical fertilizers, all of this construction work, everything is actually adding to the factors of soil erosion. Now, how can we save this? We need to save this because we know that the life of plants, animals, humans, everything is supported by soil and depends on it. So we need to preserve and conserve it. Isko bachana bahut zaruri hai. We can do it by making extra efforts made by man to prevent soil erosion, to retain fertility of soil. Now, these are few methods, bacha. Afforestation, definitely the more and more plants you have, the more trees you plant, the more it will bind the soil particles together and it will not get washed off by water, it will not get washed off by winds, erosion will be less. Checking off overgrazing. See, this is a man-made factor, so we have to keep a check on how much grazing is happening. Construction of dams and barrages, which will give a stop to all of these speedy flow of water, running water. The speed will get checked so it will not erode the soil, and improved techniques of agriculture. This is another one very major factor which affects the soil erosion. So all of these things we have basically discussed. Now, improved techniques of agriculture, maybe we can have contour methods. So basically lines, contours are made like this. So whatever gets, these lines are kind of cutting off the erosion from happening. Terrace farming, which is also step farming. So if there is a slope, okay, in on the slope, it is very easy for water to fall down, flow down, and it will carry all the particles. If you build steps on it, what will happen? It will flow down and then it will get a flat land. On flat land, its speed will reduce, so whatever it deposits it was carrying will not be eroded completely down. It will deposit over there, and then again at the next slope it may carry something, and then on the flat land it will slow down and deposit all of these things. So this will help again. So this is also done. Crop rotation, so it will keep the intact it will keep the fertility of the soil intact. Why? Because few crops need X nutrient, another crop needs Y nutrient, another crop needs Z nutrient. So if you keep rotating it, the same nutrient is not going to be continuously consumed from the soil, and the fertility, the nutrition balance can be maintained. Planting of cover crops, as I told you. Okay, then there is also something called shelter belt. Shelter belt can also be made, but it basically is planting trees in the middle of fields so that it breaks the speed of the winds. It will also reduce animals entering into the fields. Also, strip farming is something that can be done. Strip farming is that when farming is done of crops, in the middle of it, small strips of grass is planted. So that will cut off the speed when the wind is blowing very fast. It will reduce the wind speed from touching the soil, so it will not get eroded completely. Some other techniques are shift farming or slash and burn, which basically means that you do farming in one plot, then as soon as it starts getting a little less fertile, you leave that plot and then you move to another plot. So meanwhile, the previous plot will gain back its fertility and you can keep farming on the other one. Okay, and the second one, as I told you, see, belts of trees, this is what I was talking about. Shelter belts is what it is known as. Now, a quick announcement on popular demand. It is back. One last opportunity to be a part of the Vedanta JEE and NEET batches, early batches. Test date is a day after tomorrow, 4th of February 2021. Timing is 7 p.m. All you need to do, my dear students, is join this group. Okay, https://... I'm not going to read this. So this is your group link. Please make sure to join that. The subject is going to be mental ability and maths with Abhishek sir. Do not forget to miss that. This is for class 10 students specifically. And with this, we have come to the end of the session. If you have not hit the like button, hit it, my dear students. Mere pyare bachcho, do tell me how did you like the session in the comment section. And I will see you guys very, very soon in the next session. The session PDF will be available to you within next 2 to 3 hours. If not today, definitely by tomorrow. Okay? Guys, come on, make the number of likes 100. Hurry up. Thank you so much, Mohit, Mimansa, Quiz Answers Hack, Bhargavi, Suchi, Lord Hindustan Gamer, बाय नितिन, आयुष, हर्षम खान, मेहदी अब्बास, बाय एवरीवन, हैव अ ग्रेट इवनिंग रजीत, बाय बच्चा, आई विल ट्राई टू गो टू ऑफिस, तृप्ति, बाय बाय विभा, यू ऑलरेडी लाइक सो स्वीट ऑफ यू, थैंक यू सो मच, बाय वचन श्री,